Sarah, an elegant woman in her mid-thirties, was talking to two men, Richard and Joe, at the same time. It was Richard, however, who made the first move, inviting Sarah out for coffee over the weekend. When Sarah and Richard started talking to each other, they were both struck by how much they had in common. For one, they had both graduated from the same college. They also loved the same kind of movies and the same kind of music. Sarah had a great feeling about Richard. He was a perfect gentleman. He didn't try to touch her or come on too strong. Instead, he appeared to be genuinely interested in who she was and what she had to say. A couple of days later, Sarah accepted Joe's invitation to go out for dinner. The moment Joe picked her up, Sarah was taken aback by his brash behavior. Right from the start, Joe came across as selfish and self-centered. Sarah didn't care for his manners either. When they got to the restaurant, she noted with dismay that Joe never once said please or thank you to the waitstaff. To make matters worse, Joe didn't even seem that interested in anything she had to say, and he even openly disagreed with her on several occasions. Sarah didn't like his attitude. But despite the many red flags, there was something about Joe that intrigued her. Yes, he was rude and arrogant. That was true. But he was also interesting. He flirted like crazy and didn't hesitate when it came to touching her. When she got home, Sarah felt confused. She had nothing in common with Joe, but she'd still enjoyed their time together. When Richard called to schedule another date, Sarah was surprised to discover that she no longer had any interest in seeing him. Richard seemed so flat and lifeless in comparison to Joe. Asshole or not, Joe was exciting and fun to be around. For better or worse, he was exactly the type of guy Sarah found attractive. Why did Sarah choose Joe over Richard? The answer, again, comes down to attraction. Sarah felt a greater level of attraction for Joe compared to Richard. Joe's body language and actions were bolder and more confident. He wasn't afraid to call her out and disagree with her. And he wasn't afraid to signal his interest by touching her. This was in stark contrast to Richard, who came across as timid and shy in comparison. When you're on a date, talking is the easy part. Taking the interaction from friendly chit-chat to playful touch, however, is what separates the attractive man from the unattractive man. Your ability to escalate the interaction and become physical with a woman is of paramount importance. A woman knows you're interested in her the moment you ask her out. Why not demonstrate your interest in a physical way? After all, she's not dating you because she wants to be your friend.